Hello ladies and gentlemen, I'm back with some contested territory action for Balloons Monkey City, and this time I aim to break the level 100 mark for the first time in my city, which may or may not be shocking considering round 100 is fairly easy to achieve, that is if the map allows it to be. Now I've had plenty of opportunities to get to round 100. Only reason I haven't yet is due to laziness and skipping out on most of the contested territory so far. But the zigzag-like forest map should be quite achievable, as the track is long enough to give me enough room for error. The only problem is it's a forest track, meaning tax shooters and banana farms are banned. Banana farms. The tower we need, but not the tower we deserve. Farms are essential to making it to a high round. Because without it, you will earn jack shit past round 25, and you'll probably die before round 40 due to a lack of funds. So how will we go about bypassing this obstacle? By regrow farming, of course. If it works for BTD5, then why shouldn't it work for Balloons Monkey City? But once again there's another problem, because unlike BTD5, the Balloons Monkey City rounds are semi-random. Semi because the balloon spawns are the same on a specific tile, random because the balloon spawns differ between two different tiles. Luckily the solution is simple, play through the contested territory one time and pinpoint the round where regrow farming is possible, then quit and play it again to set up your regrow farm for that round. Or if you want to save time you could just play through it one time and set up your regrow farm so that it will work whenever a regrow rush suddenly comes up. But since I'm a pussy, I decided to play it safe and do it in two, and the rounds where I found regrow balloons were on round 25 and 27. Round 25 contained a small rush of regrow rainbows, which I don't know if you saw it, but I failed to create a regrow farm with it. Probably because the rush was too small and my tornado wizard wasn't able to blow back enough balloons. But you know the saying, if you fail at first, try again and you shall succeed. And such is the case with this, as on round 27 I was able to create an infinite regrow rush with a good number of ceramic balloons, so I guess it's much easier to do it with ceramics instead of rainbows. Now once you get the regrow farm up, it's time to roll. You don't just want to leave it like this and let your money counter slowly go up, because at this point you get almost nothing from balloon pops. What you want to do is sniper farm, get as many 04 snipers as you can and spam their abilities over and over until you're satisfied with how much you've farmed. In my case I have 12 snipers, which is a decent amount to have, and I end up with about 700k at the end. Which should be enough to buy a few temples and last me till round 100, as long as I don't have to buy and resell abilities. I believe you can also use the balloon trap engineers to rake in some extra cash, which I experimented for a bit, but ended up selling after because I didn't know how to collect the money, as stupid as that may sound. Well, at least I know now that you can only collect the money once the trap starts blinking red. So yeah. An Arctic wind placed under an MIB is all you will need to deal with the regrow balloons that sneak through, so no need to worry about that. I think I will end it off here, but before I go let me just add in that for this week, Ninja Kiwi was nice enough to make these first 2 days a milestone event, which overlaps the week-long occupation event. It's a good thing for me because 4 extra ancient packs for hitting round 100, yippee and hooray. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and stay tuned for future Balloons Monkey City videos. Have a tough day.
We'll be right back.